And we have learned this morning, we've been talking about
yes,
it, Wiseacre is
Wiseacre.
A know-it-all. Good thing none of us are that.
No, not
never.
At all.
I saw that.
You saw
it? And I know it is the time right now, because I'm a wiseacre. I know it all.
You know
and
it all,
see
right.
it all.
Should've known that.
Coming up next, we're going to find out what the weather is going to be like this week and how to make the best salsa around. We'll tell you all about where you can also taste test dozens of salsa and the Great Salsa Challenge coming up. Stay with us.
Don't miss the Maynada Salsa Challenge at Tempe Beach Park Saturday, April 2nd from 11 to 6. With just a $10 admission, taste over 100 salsas. Buy your discount tickets at salsachallenge.com and fries.
All right, we're here talking about salsa, and we have got the, what did we say, the Grand Poobah of salsa.
He's actually a multi-grand champ.
Wow, thank
yes.
you. I can't leave out my beautiful wife, though.
Yes, this is Tim Wilhite and Julie, his wife, who says she's the Vanna of all this because it's really Tim that came up with this recipe. Tim, this is all exciting because every year we love to be a part of My Nana's Salsa Challenge, mm-hmm. which is happening next weekend, but we're previewing, and you're sharing a recipe that not necessarily reveals all your secrets, right?
That's right, Tess. What we got here is just a quick recipe for your viewers to make, and we want to kind of show them how to do it, because what we want to do is talk about the event next Saturday on April 2nd. Mm-hmm. The event is from 11 to 6, as you know, and it benefits the Arizona Hemophilia Association, and we've been involved in this event since 1996, so it's near and dear to our heart. We love to do it, and it's at Tempe Beach Park from 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. There's about 80 competitors, and what we have is when the public comes out,
it gets bigger every year.
It's huge,
yes.
And they're going to eat over 3,000 pounds of My Nana's tortilla chips during the event, and we got live entertainment, like my good friends from Champagne Tap mm-hmm. will be out there playing some music for us. We got the Cazadores margarita mix-off that'll be happening. We have a kid zone for all the kids that come out, so they can have a good time jumping on the jumpy mm-hmm. things, and maybe I'll even get in there once or twice, too. I'm a big kid at
oh,
heart.
Oh, here it is. Okay, so this is video of last year. Out there.
Yeah, and in the past years, I've had a chance to be out there, got to be a judge with you
yeah.
one time.
Yes, ma'am. I hope you can help us out again.
This Saturday, unfortunately, I can't, but I won't be able to be there, but that's why I wanted to make sure we tried to promote it, because it's just
excellent.
Such a great event.
Thank
and
you.
I have to tell you, boy, when they tell you it's hot, bring along some sour cream or some milk, because when it's hot, right, Tim?
It is. It's that's absolutely right. So what do you say we make a little bit of
sure.
salsa?
Sure. Now, what is this one that we're making? What do you have a name for this one?
We do, as a matter of fact, and I think it'll be on your website because we've made it several times. But this is Timoteo's Fiesta Salsa, and you can just Google Timoteo's Fiesta Salsa or check out azfamily.com.
Okay.
So what we have here is two cans of, we're going to make it real easy. Instead of using the normal fresh tomatoes like everybody mm-hmm. likes to do, we make it easy and use the canned tomatoes, the Hunt's whole peeled tomatoes, and just rough them up a little bit like you see in the bowl there.
Okay.
So two 28-ounce cans of those. And then next what we're going to add is we're going to add two yellow hots, which is our yellow hot chilies there.
Yellow
and
hot.
The yellow hot chilies, okay. Now these add a lot of flavor to the salsa, so we think it's very important to make sure that gets into your salsa.
Does it make it hot though, or is it just a lot of flavor?
Are you keeping the seeds too?
Absolutely.
Okay.
You know, and what's ironic is it's not so much the seeds that provide the heat, it's the veins in the chilies themselves that actually give
it
a lot of
the
fire.
I thought it was the seeds.
It's the seeds contribute, but the
okay.
veins have a lot of the heat too. So if you want to reduce it down to one chili, that's fine, but for this recipe
gotcha.
We use two
we
of the
like
yellow
hot.
Hots chopped
okay.
up. Next, we're going to go with the jalapeno pepper. We got to put a jalapeno pepper on
yes.
there. Now, to give you an idea, jalapeno pepper is about 5,000 Scoville units. And in some of our hotter salsas that we make, we use a habanero chili, which is about 500,000 Scoville
Woo!
Units.
That's
about
a big difference.
It up, huh?
And Vanna, you're doing a fabulous job, by
Isn't
the way.
She's amazing. Look at her. And then, obviously, you want to use about half a cup of cilantro. Smell that, Tess.
Nice and fresh.
Like
nice and fresh.
All right. And then when you make your cilantro, you just want to tear it like this here and get that nice pungent of the cilantro to come
okay.
out and mix in the salsa. So about a half cup.
You're
of this
chopping
recipe.
That up, though, with a regular knife. Like,
oh,
right?
you betcha.
Tearing it? You're not tearing it.
No, we chop
okay.
it up nice and
okay.
get a nice consistency like you see there.
Okay.
Nextly, what we want to go ahead and do is we're going to use our scallions. We take a nice green onion like you see here. We're going to use about a half cup of scallions, and I use the white part, the green part, all of it, so you get a nice pungent, oniony smell in your salsa.
And I want to make clear, you know what, someone once asked me when they saw me cook, and I was chopping up the white parts, they're like, oh, we just throw it away. I'm like, no, you use all of it.
I agree with
right?
you.
You cut off the stem.
Well,
the
yeah,
hairy
you cut
part.
Off the root.
Yeah. You get rid of the hairy part.
Gosh, it already smells.
You loving that, huh?
Can you guys smell that?
Yeah, Timoteo in the house. All right. Then I love to use green chilies, and I like to support the local folks, so of course I love Macayo's green chilies
mm-hmm.
in my salsa, nice consistency. So just 1 4-ounce can of Macayo's green chilies,
okay.
we'll dump that in there, nice job, Anna. And then last but not least,
she's
my rock. And then last but not least, we want to add salt and garlic to taste. Now, there's a little key here, though. With the garlic, I prefer that everybody use a granulated garlic.
Okay.
I think the granulated garlic gives
you
the best
flavor. You don't want fresh.
Well, fresh is a good option. I like fresh, but to keep it simple, just get a granulated garlic, a little bit of salt, you stir it up, and this is going to be a nice salsa to kick back by the pool over the summer, this summer, have a nice libation, a margarita.
Yes. Oh, darn. There's already chips ready for us to taste.
Imagine
with.
That. So please, jump on in here right now.
All right, we're going
to
dip.
We have to jump right in here.
Julie, is this one of your favorites that Tim makes?
I like it hotter. I like the hotter
That's
version
my girl.
Of
she
it.
Likes it hot.
All right, let's put the information on your screen one last time, folks. Next Saturday, Tempe Beach Park. My Nana's Salsa Challenge, the place to be. Mm. And you know what? It's $10 to get in. You get to taste 10,000 salsas. I mean, that's not 10,000. Literally,
it's close enough.
Enough. And kids 12 and under are free.
Free. And if you want to get tickets ahead of time, they're $8 at Fry's Food Stores
fantastic.
Or online at salsachallenge.com.
Yep.
All right. Oh, man, now I'm bummed I can't be there from judging because this is...
What do you think? Not bad, huh?
Yeah.
All
Can
right,
I take home
stuff.
This one?
Well, we're going to leave that for you guys to snack all day.
All right. There you go. Thank you so much, Tim and Julie.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you, Tim. All the successes. Yeah.
Thank you very much. We appreciate it.
All right. On the entertainment front, it looks like actress Reese Witherspoon. I've had too much salsa, I can tell, because my mouth... has the salsa taste from the salsa earlier. Okay. Let's move on to this.
Yeah, too much salsa. I was working. She was eating.
Can I just say this... Okay, so we're talking about the Nana's, My Nana's Salsa Festival, which happens next Saturday. And then our salsa maker, who was a grand champion many times, Tim Whitheight, apparently from being the grand champion for so many years, he failed to tell us that he now has his own line of salsas sold at, different stores around the valley. Isn't that cute? So this one is pineapple mango. Mm. And he said this is excellent on things like fish or chicken.
Yeah, and there's a lot of things going on this upcoming weekend and this next month here that if you have questions about it, please feel free to ask us, even through Facebook.
So that's it for now, folks, but make sure you come on out and join us at the Salsa Challenge. We'll see you there.